In Book 5, The Dead Hand, Chapter 46 of Middlemarch, the Reform Bill of 1831 is being debated in Middlemarch, and Ladislaw encourages Brooke to wait to run for office, because now is the time to educate people with political meetings and through editorials in The Pioneer. Most of the people in town consider Ladislaw to be a foreign intruder with radical ideas. In Chapter 47, Ladislaw starts thinking that perhaps he's making a fool of himself in promoting Brooke for office. Still, pining for Dorothea, he decides to go to Sunday services at church so he can catch a glimpse of her. Dorothea is agitated when she sees him. Casaubon completely ignores him. In Chapter 48, Casaubon tells Dorothea they will now begin marking passages from his voluminous notebooks for inclusion in the Key to All Mythologies. But she's lost faith in his life's work. Casaubon asks Dorothea whether she will carry out his wishes in the case of his death, but won't tell her what they are. Dorothea is terrified that he wants her to promise to continue his work after he's dead. Torn, she finally is ready to promise, and when she finds Casaubon, he's dead in the garden. In Chapter 49, Sir James wishes there were a way to prevent Dorothea from learning that Casaubon has added a codicil in his will, which says that she forfeits his fortune if she marries Will Ladislaw. He wants Brooke to send Ladislaw away, but Brooke needs him for the election. In Chapter 50, after staying for a bit with her sister, Dorothea wishes to return home to peruse Casaubon's papers. Celia breaks the bad news about the codicil. Dorothea has a series of epiphanies. First, she feels repulsion for Casaubon, who's hidden his thoughts from her. Second, she feels a strange yearning towards Ladislaw. Mr. Casaubon is becoming more desperate in his quest for an earthly immortality. He treats Dorothea as a thing, not a woman, to be used entirely for his own purposes, which is why he expects her to make a promise without knowing its content. When Dorothea finds out about the codicil, she's finally able to release herself from her prison of guilt and see Casaubon for what he really is, a petty tyrant. It's not surprising that she suddenly longs for Will, who's finely tuned to her feelings and has shown her nothing but care and compassion.